So you got some new fish and you're wondering what is the best way to add those fish to your tank? In this video, we are going to answer that question. Hope you enjoy the video. Hello everyone, this is Jason from Primetime Aquatics. And yes, in this video, we are actually doing part 4 of the beginner's series to keeping an aquarium. And in today's video, we are going to be looking at how to properly add fish to your aquarium. Because there's a number of different ways you can do it. And in my opinion, for most people, there is one way that is the best way, and that's what we're going to do today. So here we've got our fish, and in this particular bag, we've got a couple of black mollies, and we are going to be adding them to the tank right behind me, and that is our 50-gallon lowboy. So let's go ahead and talk about a couple different ways that we can do this. Way number one is something called drip acclimation, in which we slowly take water from our tank that we're going to add the fish to and add it to the bag. The second way that we can do this is something commonly known as the plop and drop, where we are going to let the fish temperature acclimate. And then after about 15 or 20 minutes, we're going to put them in a net and put them in the tank. What I wanted to do today is not only show you what we do, but discuss why and explain why it's beneficial to do the fish acclimation the way that we do it. So no matter which direction we go, the first thing we want to do is temperature acclimate our fish. This is really important. Often when we get fish from a pet store and we transport them home, especially if it's in a colder climate, the water temperature in the bag can actually go down. And so we want to make sure that we're matching the temperature in our tanks to the temperature in the bag. That's going to reduce stress. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and just put this bag in our tank and we're going to float the bag. Now this bag is going to stay in that temperature, in that tank water for around 15 to 20 minutes. We don't need to be in a big hurry here unless you've had a very long transport time. But for most people, when they go to the fish store and bring their fish home, we're probably looking at a transit time of less than a half an hour. So here we're just gonna go ahead and let the temperatures of both the bag water and the tank water acclimate. They're going to become the same, and that's going to help, like I said, reduce the stress on our fish. One of the things that we're trying to reduce is the amount of stress that our fish undergo through this transportation process. The reason we want to do that is when fish are stressed, their immune system becomes compromised, and when that happens, they are more prone to disease. The second thing, I'm not showing it here, but what I highly recommend is turn the lights off in your tank. This can be especially true if you're introducing cichlids or more aggressive fish to an established tank. I have found I have by far the most success when the fish are placed in a tank where the fish tank lights are not on. I know this can be difficult to do because we've got a brand new fish and we want to see them, but trust me, it's going to reduce the amount of stress the fish feel. You won't have fish picking at the bags or looking at them. And especially when it comes to cichlids, as some of you may know, when you put those cichlids in the tank at first, they get chased around. When the lights are off, that's not going to happen. It's going to give them a chance to settle down, get used to their environment. And then later on in a few hours, when you turn the lights on, those fish will already be present. And there's a chance that they may be ignored by a lot of the other fish in the tank. So while the fish are temperature acclimating to the tank, I wanted to take a couple minutes and talk about the two main methods of getting fish acclimated, and that is drip acclimation and the plop and drop method. And I want to talk about the science reason behind why we don't use drip acclimation. So first thing, when fish are placed in a bag, they're going to be releasing two different waste products. One is ammonia, and that can be very toxic to fish. The other thing that they're going to be releasing, just like we do, is CO2. Now, ammonia, as I've mentioned, can be toxic, but it exists in two different forms. And in fact, I did a video in much greater detail on this subject. I'm going to put it in the upper right-hand corner, as well as in the description below if you want more information. But the ammonia that is being released, as I said, can be toxic. But there are two things that are going to happen when we're transporting the fish that are going to make that ammonia less toxic. The first thing is, ammonia and its toxicity is dependent upon temperature. The lower the temperature, the less toxic the ammonia is. So when we're transporting the fish, naturally what's going to happen is the water temperature is going to decrease a little bit. The second thing that's going to happen is as the fish release the CO2 into the water, it will be converted to something called carbonic acid. And so as the pH goes down, that also makes the ammonia less toxic. And so while the fish are producing this toxic ammonia, the decrease in the pH along with the decrease in the temperature is keeping it less toxic than it would normally be. So when we get our fish home, we put the bag in the tank to get the temperatures acclimated. So what we're doing is we're increasing the temperature. That potentially could make the ammonia a little bit more toxic. However, the pH is still low, and that pH plays a bigger role in making sure the ammonia the fish produced stays relatively non-toxic. If you were to use the drip acclimation method, what would happen is you would simply take a pair of scissors or maybe put the fish with the water in a bucket and then slowly drip the water from the tank into the bucket. The problem with that is as soon as you open that bag, that carbonic acid, the CO2, is released, and that immediately increases the pH of the water in the bag. And so now what have we done? We've increased the temperature and we increased the pH, and now we've converted that non-toxic ammonia into a more toxic form, and that can be very stressful to fish and damaging to their health. All right, so now that our fish have been temperature acclimating for around 15 to 20 minutes, we just need a couple things to get the fish into the tank. The first thing we're going to need is a net. We're going to need some type of container because we do not, under any circumstances, want the fish store water going into our tank. One, because there could be harmful waste products, and two, you just never know if the water itself could be harboring some kind of fish disease. And so we definitely don't want the water from the bag going into the tank, and that's why I have this container here. The next thing you're most likely going to want is a pair of scissors. I find it's just easiest to cut the top of the bag off, place the net over our bucket or whatever you've got, and then just put the fish in here, take the fish out, right in the tank we go. And so that's what we're going to do. So we have our net. We can go ahead and remove our bag here. Now this is going to be a little bit tricky because I only have two hands and I need three hands. So if you need to have somebody help you with this step, by all means, go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this. And right now at this point, when I talked about the drip acclimation, this is when the pH starts to go up because I just released all of that CO2 and I've released all of the oxygen, and now we've got potential issues. So I'm gonna go ahead and pour this in slowly. Oops. And there we go. So now my fish are out. I usually like to kind of hold a net like this just in case they like to jump, and then I keep it held in, and in they go. Again, this particular container is going to wind up, the water is going to go into the sink. Now, one thing I do want to mention, in this particular scenario that we have going on here, I pulled these, for the purposes of the video, I pulled these fish out of this tank and then put them right back in. If I were buying new fish, there is no way that I would put new fish in an established tank. I would use a quarantine tank. And so we see all these 10-gallon tanks behind me. One of their jobs is when we get in new fish, I don't ever put them immediately into one of my established tanks. The new fish, everything I just explained here, the new fish would go into a quarantine tank and they would stay there for 4 weeks to make sure that they don't have any fish disease. And if they do, that's where they get treated, and then I would keep them in there another 4 weeks after successful treatment. If you want more information about how to quarantine fish, I highly recommend check out this video in the upper right-hand corner. I'll put it in the description below as well, but I just want to be really clear. Under no circumstances will I put fish from a fish store into an established tank because I don't want to run the risk of introducing disease. All right, everyone. So that is how we introduce fish into usually a quarantine tank, to be clear. If you want more information, again, about our quarantine process, check out this video in the upper right-hand corner. If you want to learn more about how that ammonia can be toxic, check out the video in the lower right-hand corner. I will also put the entire beginner series in the description below. Appreciate you being here, and we'll see you in the next one.